Hello friends, this is your physics lecture taught by Tale Madam. Here we study another important part of current electricity, which is drift velocity. What is the drift velocity? Whenever any conductor is connected to external battery, due to the battery, the positive charges are collected at one side, negative charges are collected at another side. Due to the charges, electric field is generated inside the conductor. As this electric field applies the force on charge particle, electrons are the free moving charge. Due to the electric field, the electrons are drifted in opposite direction and electrons are drifted move in opposite direction of electric field with particular velocity called as drift velocity. So drift velocity we can find as it is acceleration into tau. Tau is a relaxation time. It is the time interval between two successive collision. When the electrons are moving inside the conductor, they will collide with the core part of the positive charge, that is the nucleus, and during that successive time interval between two collision is the relaxation time. So this is the acceleration into tau. What is the acceleration? It is force upon mass. Force applied by the electric field on the electron is E into E upon mass of electron into relaxation time. This one is the equation. Another one you can remember, the drift velocity is nothing but current upon NEA. Current upon N, number of electron, number of charge per unit volume, per unit meter cube, into E, charge on electron, A, area of cross section. Okay, and what is current upon area? It is the J, current density upon NE. And we know what is the current density. The current density is current density is nothing but sigma into E divided by NE. This one is another relation, or the same relation we can write as E is equal to potential difference divided by what is E. Electric field is nothing but potential difference between the two plates divided by distance between them. Here electric field is V. Potential difference between two and distance between two is nothing but distance between both the sides of conductor is nothing but length. So it is V by L. Sigma is nothing but 1 by rho into NE. So this is how we can write the different forms of drift velocity. According to requirement we use any form. Drift velocity is also dependence quantity. It is not constant because drift velocity is directly proportional to electric field. Electric field, what is the direction of electric field? Drift velocity is directed in opposite. Okay, direction is opposite. Electric field is directed in this direction, but drift velocity, electrons are drifted in opposite direction of electric field. But it is directly proportional to electric field, and this drift velocity is also inversely proportional to area. So according to similar to the current density, the drift velocity is also variable. For example, whatever the conductor, if the shape of the conductor is uniform, then whatever the drift velocity or the velocity of the electron moving inside the conductor is same, is constant. Drift velocity is constant when the shape of the conductor is uniform. But whenever the shape of conductor is non-uniform, here the electric field is also non-uniform, that is also variable. So drift velocity is also variable. Drift velocity is here not constant. So here also you can consider, this one is the direction of electric field. Here we can consider any two point P and Q, as at point P electric field is greater than at point Q. So drift velocity at point P is also greater than drift velocity at point Q, same as a current density. So here you have to remember the current is constant. Current is constant, but whatever current density, electric field and the drift velocity are not constant. It depends on the shape of the conductor. Okay, but current does not depend on the shape of conductor. It remains constant in both the conditions. So using this, we can solve some of the example. This one is one of the example asked for JEE Main. When 5 volt potential difference is applied, what they are given? V is given as 5 volt. Applied a wire of length. Length is given 0.1 meter. Drift speed of electron. Speed is given. Drift velocity is given 2.5 into 10 power minus 4 meter per second. If electron density in the wire is given, electron density in the wire means Number of electrons are given 8 into 10 power 28 per meter cube. What we have to find? Resistivity of material. We have to find resistivity. Now, this resistivity, how we find? We use the one form of drift velocity. Vd is equal to whatever the drift velocity is equal to V, potential difference upon rho lne. So, drift velocity is equal to V divided by rho lne. Rearrange this. What we get here, rho is equal to potential difference upon drift velocity lne. Put the values, rho V is given 5, Vd is given 2.5 into 10 power minus 4, length 0.1, number of electron 8 into 10 power 28, charge on electron 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. Solve this. Divide by 5, we get 0.5. Now, 1.6 into 0.5 is 16 into 5, 80. That is 0.8. 0.8 into 8 is 6.4. Right? Power 10 power 0.1 minus 1 minus 4 minus 5 minus 5 minus 19 is 24. Minus 24 plus 28 plus 4. So it is 10 power plus 4. Okay? So, the 10 power plus 4 take shift upward, and when we take this reciprocal or when we solve, we get some answer. Here they have given the answer. All the answers are 16 ones. Obviously, here we get 0.16 as an answer. Only just we have to check the power. So, rearrange this, we will get 1.6 into 10 power minus 5. So, the correct option is D option, ohm meter. So, this is how we solve the equation. Next. Using this, we can also solve the different question. For example, a uniform copper wire of length 1 meter. Here also they have given length is given 1 meter. Cross-section area is given 5 into 10 power minus 7. Carries a current 1 ampere. Assuming that there are 8 into 10 power 28 number of electron, 8 into 10 power 28 electron per meter cube. In copper, how long will an electron take to drift from one end of wire to other end? How long? Means we have to find time. So what is the time? We know the speed is nothing but distance upon time. Speed is nothing but distance upon time. Time is nothing but distance upon velocity, right? But here, what the distance is? Distance is nothing but electron drift from one end of wire to another end. One end to another end. The distance between 2 is nothing but length. So here it is length upon drift velocity. Length L upon what is the drift velocity? It is the current divided by NEA. Apply the values. We get L is 1. N is given 8 into 10 power 28. Charge on electron is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. Area of cross section 5 into 10 power minus 7. Current is given 1 ampere. Solve it. 16 into 5, 0.8, 0.8 into 8, which is 6.4 into 10 power minus 19 minus 7 minus 26, 28, it is plus 28. So, 6.4 into 10 power 4, 1.6 into 5, it is 80, 80 into 8, it is 64. So, 64 into 10 power 2. So, what the answer they have given? 6.4 into 10 power 3. So, when we rearrange, it is 6.4 into 10 power 3 second is the answer. So, this is how we can solve this type of example. Another one example. Here, this example is based on the semiconductor. So, what they have given? Here, they have given ratio of concentration of electron to that of hole. Concentration of electron to that of hole. That means number of electrons and number of hole ratio is given, which is 7 by 5. Next, ratio of current is given. Current electron and current due to hole is given 7 by 4. And we have to find their drift velocity. Vd electron and Vd due to hole we have to find. So here we use the same formula. What is the current? Current is equal to NEA Vd, right? Means current is directly proportional to number of electron, number of hole and VD, drift velocity. So use the same relation, or you can directly use this relation also. VD is equal to current upon NEA, PD is directly proportional to current, inversely proportional to number of electron. So VD electron upon VD hole is equal to current due to electron upon current due to hole into inversely. So number of hole divided by number of electron. Current IE upon IH, they have given 7 by 4. And whatever this, we will reverse 5 by 7. 7 will be cancelled. So this will be 5 by 4. This one is the answer. Okay. So this is how we solve this type question. Another one different type question we solve. Number of free electron per 100 mm of ordinary copper is given. So here number of free electron, number of electron per length is given. And whenever number of electron per length is given, how we convert? Here number of electron n is equal to whatever the number of electron per unit length. So how you find n? N is always number of electron per unit volume, and what this number volume is area into length, right? So we put this value in the equation. Current is equal to NEAVD. N is equal to N upon A into L EAVD. This area cancel. So the formula, new formula for this is N upon L EVD. So whenever number of electron per unit length is given, we use this formula. Okay, so apply the same here also. Number of electron per 100 mm of ordinary copper wire is given, means number of electron n is given, 2 into 10 power 21 per 100 mm, per 100 mm is given. Here I will put mm as it is, because here the drift velocity is also given in mm. So what is the charge? 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. VD is given 0.25 mm per second. So both the mm cancel. Multiply this. You will get 0.25 into 2. That is 0.5. 0.5 into 1.6 is 0.8 into 10 power. Whatever 10 power remaining is 2. And divided by 100. So the answer is 0.8. ampere. So this one is the correct answer. So this one is another formula, just we have to remember. Another formula I will suggest you have to remember, you can remember generally that type question will also ask. You can solve one question from SC Verma. They have given in this way. Whenever they have given number of free electrons per atom, at this condition, whatever number of electron we find, or instead of N we put as Avogadro number Na, X that is the number of electron per atom into density, I will write D, divided by whatever the molar mass M, okay, atomic mass of that material, that copper or any material they will give. So when you put this value in the equation, what we get? Drift velocity is current upon NEA. So it is, N is nothing but Avogadro number, X number of electron per atom, D is the density, divided by molecular weight will be shifted above, INEA. So this one is the formula. So you can put this formula, you can use this formula to find drift velocity whenever number of electron per atom is given. So these are different types of question based on the drift velocity will be asked for your exam. Thank you.